Okay, let us see the other application of integral calculus. It is known by the name Fundamental Theorem of Calculus I. It says, suppose f is a continuous function that is continuous on an interval I containing more than one point, and let a be any number in this interval. Assume that a function f, capital F, is defined this way. Capital F of x is the integral from a to x of small f of t dt. These are two different functions. This integrand is small f, and this one is capital F. For every x in I, then capital F is differentiable. If capital F is defined in this way, then you will find capital F to be a differentiable function, and its derivative is equal to the integrand function, that is small f of x. Now, let us see the application of this one. Here we have given capital F of x. It is defined as the integral from 1 to x of ln t dt for x greater than 0. The question is, find the derivative of this function. Now, capital F of x is nothing but the integral from 1 to x of ln t dt. The question is, find f prime at x. F prime at x, it is a matter of writing the inner function in terms of x. So you'll have simply ln x. So the integral of this function is ln x. If it were, for example, to the power of t, we'll have what? To the power of x. If it is cos t, we'll have cos x. Therefore, it is a matter of, you know, changing the variable from t to x. So you have ln x. So f prime at x is ln x. The second one, find the derivative of this function, the integral from x to 2 of t square e power t dt. The question is, find the derivative with respect to x of the integral from x to 2 of t square e power t dt. As you remember, the fundamental theorem of calculus 1 says, if capital F of x is written in the form a, from a to x of f of t dt. Here, the lower limit of integration is constant, the upper is a variable. If that is so, f prime at x is capital, small f of x. Now, in this case, the lower limit of integration is not a constant, rather it is a variable, but the upper limit of integration is a variable, it is a constant, it has to be a variable. So, we can change this as the integral from x to 2 can be written as the negative of the integral from 2 to x of t square e power t dt. Now let's take the negative out, the negative of the derivative with respect to 2 of the integral from 2 to x of t square e power t dt. And obviously we can apply here the fundamental theorem of calculus 1, and the derivative will be, it is a matter of replacing t by x. So you have x square e power x times negative 1, or simply minus x square e power x. This is the derivative. So the derivative is minus x square e power x. The last one, we have given a function capital F in this way. Capital F of x is the integral from 2 to x, from 2x to 7x, e power t cos t, e power t cos t cos t dt. Now we can write this as the integral from 2x to a certain constant k, e power t cos t dt, plus from that constant k to 7x, 7x e power t cos t dt. Now, since the constant must be in the lower limit of integration, we can write this as
the integral from t to 2x of e power t cos t dt, plus this is the integral from t to 7x e power t cos t dt. Now, what is the derivative of f of x? The derivative of f of x is the derivative of this one. It is a matter of replacing t by 2x. So I'll have e power 2x cosine of t. T is what? 2x. Times, it is composition. What is the derivative of 2x? It is 2. Plus, let's substitute 7x in place of t here. So I'll have e power 7x cosine of 7x times the derivative of 7x, that is 7. So I'll have minus 2 e power 2x cos 2x plus 7 times e power 7x cos 7x. This is the derivative of f at x. But what we are asked is to find the derivative at 0. So we'll have the derivative of f at 0 will be negative 2 e the power of 0 cos 0 plus 7 e power 0, this is 0, cosine 0. Obviously, this is 1, so you'll have negative 2, this is 1 times 7 is 7, and the sum will be 5. Therefore, the derivative of f at 0 will be 5. So by this we have come to the end of applications of integral calculus. So far we have seen about 5 or 6 different applications of integral calculus.